President Museveni has summoned National Resistance Movement NRM MPs to his farm in Chisozi, Gomba District, amidst debate on the controversial Coffee Amendment Bill. According to Government Chief Whip Dennis Oboa, the meeting is scheduled to take place on Friday this week. Although the letter does not indicate the exact agenda for the meeting, Oboa said that the president and the members will discuss different issues that affect the country. Speaker of Parliament Anita Among last week adjourned Parliament to a future date after he hit a debate and vote on the controversial bill to transfer the functions of the Uganda Coffee Development Authority to the Mother Agriculture Ministry. While majority of the opposition members opposed the transfer, the NRM voted for the transfer. The House, in the interest of equity, the Speaker subjected the bill to a division lobby headcount vote outside the chamber, as per Rule 101 of the Rules of Procedure. When the vote was finally tallied, 77 MPs voted against the motion for second reading of the bill, while 159 MPs voted in support. UCDA was established in 1991 under the Uganda Coffee Development Authority Act CAP 325, which repealed and replaced the National Coffee Act No. 17 of 2021. Residents in Lumino Town Council in Busia District have asked the government to elevate Lumino Health Center 3 to Health Center 4 to help improve health service delivery. According to a report, the facility registers over 200 patients in the outpatient department OPD per month. According to residents, this causes congestion at the OPD, thereby creating poor service delivery due to lack of enough medics, leading to some being referred to the district hospital, which is 8 kilometers away. Busia District Health Officer Dr. Wabire Mathias Panyako says that they are done with writing a report to inform the health ministry about the situation in Lumina Health Center 3, that it needs to be elevated due to the increasing number of patients.
As technical people, we did that. The politicians passed our suggestion in the district council. So what is required is following up on what we communicated to Ministry of Health. And now following up, anybody is mandated to follow up. As the technical people, we do follow up. But also the political, you know, political voice weighs so much.
Godfrey Were Odero, the MP for Samia Bugwe South constituency, promised to make a follow-up for the elevation of the Health Center 3 to Health Center 4.
You realize that Health Center 2 of Mundindi, it receives people from Namaingo and other places, Kenya, and also the people who are in my constituency. It is over congested. You find that the number of women giving birth in that health center too is high.
And since we get so many mothers who deliver, find that if you have three or more mothers who are delivering, you get a difficulty of what? Handling them. And not because that you don't have a health worker, but because of the spacing. The spacing, you cannot put any other bed in this room here apart from those two.
Odero lauded the government for coming up with different projects to transform people's lives. He, however, cited the need to focus on health service delivery. Republican Donald Trump led a headline-grabbing New York rally on Sunday with non-stop attacks on Kamala Harris, but Democrats sought to capitalize on crude insults from some of his allies. Opening speech, Trump took to the stage at the iconic 20,000-seat Madison Square Garden Arena to deliver a closing message in the exceedingly tight race for the White House that reaches its apex on November 5th.
Next Tuesday, you have to stand up and you have to tell Kamala Harris that you've done a terrible job, that crooked Joe Biden has done a terrible job. You've destroyed our country. We're not going to take it anymore.
He accused Kamala Harris of destroying the United States. U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris rolled up to Philly Cut's barbershop in the largely black neighborhood of West Philadelphia to meet residents before ducking into the African-American-themed Hakim's bookstore and gift shop.
Make no mistake, we will win. We will win. We will win. Donald Trump, who spends full time looking in the mirror, focused on himself.
On Tuesday, Harris will hold a major rally in Washington near the White House, in the park where Trump fired up his supporters before they stormed the U.S. Capitol to try to overturn the 2020 election result.